Hello students, we are the continuation lectures of civil chemistry. For previous video, we can see the link that is given in the description. So now here in this video, let us discuss the calculation of the stereoisomers. Okay? So in a calculation of the stereoisomers or optical isomers, so there are the two cases. The one is if molecule is symmetric and other one is the molecule is unsymmetric. Okay? So first of all, let us discuss the when the molecule is a unsymmetric molecule. That means the molecule is not a symmetric molecule. In those cases, how many isomers are possible? Okay, let us discuss. So here, first one is when molecule is not symmetric. When molecule is not symmetric, number of stereoisomers. Number of stereoisomers or optical isomers. Number of stereoisomers or optical isomers equals to 2 power of n, where n is number of stereogenic centers. Okay, number of stereogenic centers. Okay, here stereogenic centers means including chiral carbons. Plus C double bond C also. Okay? Chiral carbons and C double bond C. We know that here the C double bond C also stereogenic center. About the C double bond C, we can see two different type of stereoisomers. First, suppose it is a cis 1,2 dichloroethane and this is the trans 1,2 dichloroethane. Okay? So about this C double bond C stereogenic center, we can see the two stereoisomers. So it is a stereogenic center. Okay. Now here about the chiral carbon, we can see the two different isomers. For suppose you see this one CH3 and this is C2H5. Here above the plane OH and below the plane hydrogen. Okay, it is a 2-butanol. It is a one stereoisomer and here its mirror image. For suppose CH3. And C2H5. Here, this above the plane hydrogen and this below the plane OH. So about this carbon center, here we have a two spatial arrangements. Okay, about this carbon center, we have a two different spatial arrangements, and about this C double bond C center, we have a two different spatial arrangements. So here, the chiral carbon is a stereogenic center, and the double bond is also stereogenic center. Okay, so now here. The cis trans are the stereoisomers and here these are also stereoisomers. Okay, so of course you know that this is a that means the dextro isomer, it is a Lewo isomer, or we can say one is the R isomer, one is the S isomer. Okay, if you give the absolute configuration, RS configuration, one is the R isomer, other one is the S isomer. Okay, these two are the stereoisomers, these two are the stereoisomers. Okay. Now here, about the one stereogenic center, we can see the two stereoisomers, okay? Either about the chiral carbon, either about the C double bond C, we can see the two different stereoisomers, okay? So now here, the N is number of stereogenic center. That means here number of chiral carbons and the number of double bonds, okay? That means here, the double bond means here, just we have to take the double bonds across which geometrical isomerism possible. First, suppose here you can see, CH2 double bond CH, CH double bond CH, CH and CH3, this one OH, okay? So this is one compound having C double bond C and one chiral carbon. So then here, what is the N value actually? Here N value is only 2, because about this double bond geometrical isomerism is not possible, about this double bond geometrical isomerism is possible. And about this chiral carbon, of course, stereoisomerism, nothing but optical isomerism possible. Now here in this exam, in this molecule, just we have to take the N value 2 only, because about this one 2 stereoisomers possible, about this one 2 stereoisomers possible, here about the C double bond C, stereoisomers are not possible. So it is not a stereogenic center. Okay, so N equals to 2. So here number of stereoisomers are optical isomers. Number of stereoisomers are optical isomers, 2 power of 2, that equals to 4. 2 power of 2, that equals to 4. What are those 4 isomers? You see this one, when about the C double bond C configuration is cis, and then here configuration may be R. Okay? its mirror image cis and s. Okay, the mirror image of cis isomer is a cis actually. Okay, mirror image of the chiral carbon having R configuration s actually. Okay, now here trans R configuration, its mirror image also trans s configuration. Okay, these two are the mirror images, these two are the mirror images. So it is a one enantiomeric pair, this is a another enantiomeric pair. So here whenever in this case when the molecule is an unsymmetric molecule, the number of cis isomers equals 2^n, the number of enantiomeric pairs 2^n/2. Okay, number of enantiomeric pairs 2^n/2, that means here 4/2. It is a one enantiomeric pair, it is a another enantiomeric pair. Okay, so here cis R and cis S are the mirror images enantiomers, trans R trans S mirror images and enantiomers. Okay, so now here for suppose cis R trans R, these two are not the mirror images because here chiral carbon configuration R, here chiral carbon configuration R, but here cis isomer, here trans isomer, these two are the diastereomers. Okay, these two are the diastereomers and these two are the diastereomers, and here these two are the enantiomers, these two are the enantiomers. Okay, that's it. Okay, cis to trans are the diastereomers. Of course you know that geometric isomers are also diastereomers. Okay, diastereomers are the isomers which are not mirror images, may be active or inactive. Okay, that's it. So you see in this case cis R isomer, trans isomer, these are not the mirror images, so these are considered as diastereomers. But here cis R isomer is optically active, trans R isomer is optically active. Okay, that's it. Yeah, okay, so here the number of cis isomers only 4 for this molecule. So now here in this case, for suppose you see here for this molecule number of geometrical isomers only. Okay, you can see the difference here, number of geometrical isomers only 2^1 and equals to 2 only. That means here if you want to own geometrical isomers, you have to consider this double bond only. Okay, that means here cis isomer, trans isomer, those are only two geometrical isomers. Okay, but when we calculate the total stereoisomers or total optical isomers, we have to include this double bond and this chiral carbon also. Okay, for calculating the all stereoisomers or for calculating the all optical isomers. Okay, that means here the cis R isomer is optically active, cis S is optically active, trans R is optically active, trans S is optically active. So here these four isomers are optically different isomers. These four isomers are optically different isomers. For suppose its optical rotation of plus 5 degrees, its optical rotation must be minus 5 degrees. Okay, for suppose its optical rotation plus 10 degrees, here optical rotation minus 10 degrees. That means your optical rotation of those molecules different. Okay, of course here these two are the mirror images having same magnitude but different direction. These two are the mirror images, that means enantiomers. Enantiomers have the same magnitude of the optical rotation but different direction. One is a dextro, one is a plio. Okay, so here these four are the optical isomers as well stereoisomers. But here if you want to calculate the only geometric isomers, just we have to consider this double bond only, because about this double bond geometric isomers are not possible. Okay, in calculation of the geometric isomers, chiral carbon no need to be counted. Okay, so here about this one only geometric isomers, cis and trans. Okay, that is important point. So here let us discuss some more examples. You see this one here, this is the chiral carbon, this is the double bond stereogenic center, this is the double bond stereogenic center. So here n equals to 3, so total stereoisomers, number of stereoisomers equals to 2^3, 8. That means here number of enantiomeric pairs, number of enantiomeric pairs equals to 8/2, that equals to 4 actually. Okay, now here for this molecule, just we want to calculate the just only geometrical isomers. Okay, so here number of geometrical isomers, number of geometrical isomers equals to 2^2, 4 only. Okay, number of geometrical isomers 2^2, 4 only. It means here just we have to consider these double bonds only for calculating the geometrical isomers. Okay, but here stereoisomers means here that includes geometrical as well as optical isomers. Okay, So here that we have to take the number of bonds as well as chiral carbons. Okay. So number of geometrical isomers 2 power of 2 equals to 4 for this molecule. Okay. Yeah. So next here see this one. Here this is the chiral carbon. This is the chiral carbon 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here about this double bond, amines also exhibit the geometrical isomerism. So here the n value equals to 7. So 2 power of 7 equals to 128. Total number of isomers 128. Number of enantiomeric pairs 128 by 2. Okay, that's it. So next here coming to this one, a simple example. See, here it is a chiral carbon. It is a chiral carbon. So actually here to calculate the geometric isomers for this one, just here only two geometric isomers, cis isomer and trans isomer. Cis isomer and trans isomer. Okay? Cis isomer and trans isomer. Just I am taking this is the unsymmetric molecule BR. Here this is a BR and this one also BR. Okay? You can see here in this case it is a cis isomer and trans isomer. These two are only two geometrical isomers. Okay? So for calculating geometrical isomers, we can take this one, this carbon-carbon bond as a single stereogenic center. But here, to calculate the total number of stereoisomers or to calculate the total number of optical isomers, here we have to take these two as a two chiral carbons. That means here n equals to 2, so here 2 power of 2, 4 isomers. How 4 isomers are possible? Here in this case here, for this one, we can take the mirror image. Okay, above the plane here Cl, below the plane here bromine, also below the plane. Now here in this case, for this one mirror image, below the plane chlorine and above the plane bromine. That means here these two are the mirror images, these two are the mirror images. Okay, so these two are the enantiomers, these two are the enantiomers. Total stereoisomers are the 4. But here geometrically different isomers, it is a cis isomer, it is also cis isomer. Geometrically same, these two. And here, above the plane, below the plane, trans isomer. Here it is also trans isomer. That means geometrically different. But here, these two are the mirror images each other. That means these two are the enantiomers. These two are the enantiomers. These are also mirror images. So here, the total optic isomers are, or total stereoisomers are the 4. So but only geometrical isomers are 2 only. Okay? That is the important point. So here, to calculate the total number of stereoisomers, these two are taken as a chiral carbon. But if you want to calculate the only geometrical isomers, here we should take this one as a single stereogenic center. Okay, there is a difference actually. That means here one stereogenic center 2 power of 1, that equals to 2. 2 are the only geometrical isomers. But here to calculate the total stereoisomers, just here 2 take as 2 chiral carbons, 2 power of 2, that equals to 4. Now here similarly coming to this one. You see here there is a chiral carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, here in this case 5. Okay, so about this one, after stereoisomers are possible 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is n equals to 5. Okay, n equals to 5. So number of stereoisomers, number of stereoisomers equals to 2 power of 5, that equals to 32. Okay, total stereoisomers 32. Or total optical isomers 32. Okay, here in this case the molecule is a unsymmetric molecule, all isomers are the optically active. Okay, that's it. Now here coming to this one here. You see, this is a chiral carbon, this is a stereogenic center, this is a chiral carbon, this is a chiral carbon. So n value actually here 4. So here 2 power of 4, 16 stereoisomers. 2 power of 4, 16 stereoisomers. But here only geometrical isomers. Only geometrical isomers. Here, to calculate the only geometric isomers, this double bond should be considered and this carbon-carbon bond considered as a one stereogenic center. We know that about the 1 and 3 positions, first suppose here chlorine, first suppose this is the one group, alkyl group, okay, totally, let us say this alkyl group. So, for this one here, we can say cis isomer and trans isomer, okay, cis isomer, trans isomer. That means here, it is a one stereogenic center that generates the two stereoisomers. That's why here we have to take this one as a one stereogenic center, this is one stereogenic center to calculate the geometrical isomers 2 power of 2, that equals to 4 only. But here to calculate the total number of stereoisomers, these two are taken as a 2 chiral carbons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 power of 4, 16. That difference we have to observe. Okay, that's it. Now again here this is a 3 chiral carbon, so 2 power of 3 equals to, okay, 2 power of 3 here, sorry, 9 isomers, sorry, 8 isomers, for this one 8 isomers, okay, 2 power of 3 equals to 8, so total number of stereoisomers is 8. Of course here there is no double bond, these are the only stereoisomers are also optical isomers, 8, okay, number of enantiomeric pairs are the 4, here 8 isomers are the optically active isomers. So here we can calculate the stereoisomers for these molecules, okay, and give your answer in a comment box. Now here one of the previous JEE advanced question, that is number of enantiomeric pairs for camphor, okay, number of enantiomeric pairs for camphor. This camphor can be written also like this. This methyl, this is a methyl, methyl, double bond O. For camphor actually 2 chiral carbons are there. Okay. So here N equals to 2. So stereoisomers must be 2 power of 2, 4. That means here enantiomeric pairs must be 2 only. Okay. Total number of stereoisomers 4. So enantiomeric pairs must be 2. But here camphor is a bicyclic, that means a bridged bicyclic compound. It is a bridged bicyclic compound. So here about this carbon, your configuration is not to be changed, okay, about this carbon. You can see here in this case, this hydrogen always below the plane, this methyl always above the plane, okay. Those positions are fixed because this is a bridged bicyclic compound, okay. These two carbons are connected by this one carbon bridge, okay. So that's why here, this is blocked. So here methyl always above the plane, here hydrogen always below the plane, okay. So here 2 power of 2 equals to 4, this formula is not applicable for this one, okay, it is a rigid molecule. So now here how many enantiomeric pairs are possible, that means here only one enantiomeric pair, it means only two isomers, methyl, methyl, here hydrogen below the plane, here double bond, just here we can take its mirror image only, okay, we can take the mirror image only, methyl, methyl. So here methyl, this is a double bond, okay, these two are the only two possible stereoisomers and it means one enantiomeric pair, okay, that's it, okay. Now here you see this one, for this compound we can see methyl, methyl, here methyl, double bond, okay. So or for suppose like here there is a OH group, OH group. So here in this case, how many chiral carbons are there? This is the one chiral carbon, second chiral carbon, third chiral carbon. N equals to 3 actually. Number of chiral carbons 3. So but here number of stereoisomers are not 8 isomers. Okay. So here in this case, how many isomers are possible? So here in this one, here hydrogen upward direction, here OH downward direction. So here we can see its mirror image. Okay. You can see here its mirror image. Here this is the OH and here a hydrogen, methyl, okay. Now here we can see another enantiomeric pair, that is here OH upward direction, here a hydrogen downward direction. Now here we can take the mirror image. So here this is OH, here a hydrogen, methyl, methyl, this is methyl. So here for this compound, total stereoisomers are the 4. That means the 2 enantiomeric pairs, because one extra chiral carbon is there. So about this carbon, we can change the orientation. But here about this bridgehead carbon, we cannot change the orientation because that is blocked by the one carbon bridge. Okay, that's it. So now here, these two are the enantiomers, these two are the enantiomers. For suppose, the relation between these two are the diastereomers. Because in this case here, these are not the mirror images. Here, OH downward, here OH upward. Okay. That means actually here this is called as an endoisomer. This is also endoisomer, downward direction endo, and upward direction exoisomer, upward direction exoisomer. Okay. For suppose let us say it is a dextroisomer, then it is a levoisomer. Exo dextroisomer, exo levoisomer. Here endo dextroisomer, endo levoisomer. Of course, we cannot say which is a dextroisomer, which is a levoisomer. That is must be decided by the polar emitter experiment. If it is a levo, then it is a dextro. Okay, that's it. So next year, second case, that is if molecule is symmetric, that means here if the molecule can be cut into two equal halves, in that case how to calculate the stereoisomers or optical isomers. So actually here, if molecule is symmetric, some isomers are optically active, some isomers are optically inactive. Okay, let us discuss. Here n is even, then total stereoisomers equals to 2 power of n minus 1 plus 2 power of n by 2 minus 1. So here number of active isomers, number of optically active isomers equals to 2 power of n minus 1. Now number of optically inactive isomers. Inactive isomers are also called as a mesoisomers in this case. Okay, mesoisomers. So that equals to 2 power of n by 2 minus 1. So here the enantiomers must be optically active. So number of optically active isomers, 2 power of n minus 1 by 2, that equals to number of enantiomeric pairs. Okay, now next another case, n is odd. Then here number of stereoisomers, 2 power of n minus 1 only. Okay, 2 power of n minus 1. Okay, when you calculate the number of geometric isomers, that formula is different. That is the 2 power of n minus 1 plus 2 power of n minus 1 by 2. Okay, so here in this case, again number of optically active isomers equals to 2 power of n minus 1 minus 2 power of n by 2 minus 1. Sorry, 2 power of n minus 1 by 2. Okay, n is odd, so after subtraction we can divide it by the 2. So now here number of inactive isomers or mesoisomers equals to 2 power of n minus 1 by 2. Okay, so these are the total isomers. The total isomers subtracted, that means here 2 power of n minus 1 by 2, these are the inactive isomers. Okay, so then here in this case, this is the inactive isomers and this is the total active isomers. Okay, that's it. Now let us discuss here, see this one. So well known example, that is a tartaric acid. The tartaric acid is a symmetric molecule that can be cut into two equal halves. We know that dextro tartaric acid, levo tartaric acid and meso tartaric acid. So here if the molecule is symmetric molecule, we can see the optically active isomers and inactive isomers. Unlike the molecule is unsymmetric, the molecule is not symmetric, the molecule cannot be cut into two equal halves, in that case all isomers are optically active. Okay, so now here in this case there are the two chiral carbons. Here whatever the groups attached to this chiral carbon, the same groups also attached to this chiral carbon. So these two are the similar chiral carbons. We can say these are the similar chiral carbons. Okay, here COOH hydrogen attached to this one. Here also OH hydrogen COH attached to this carbon. Okay, now here n equals to 2, that is a even number. So total stereoisomers equals to 2 power of 2 minus 1 plus 2 power of 2 by 2 minus 1, that equals to 2 plus 1 equals to 3. That means here these two are the active isomers. So active isomers only two, that is a dextro and levo, that is a one enantiomeric pair, and inactive isomers nothing but meso compound only one. Okay, that's it. Number of meso compounds and number of inactive isomers. Here one point we should notice here, the meso compounds are also optical isomers. Of course those are the optically inactive isomers, but those are the optical isomers, just I am saying. Okay, they are the optically active optical isomers, this is the optically inactive optical isomer. Okay, that's it. I am repeating again the statement. So optical isomers are the two types, optically active optical isomers and optically inactive optical isomers. So optically inactive optical isomers are the meso compounds, optically active optical isomers are the dextro, levo, those are. Okay, Now here you can see here in this case CH3CH3, here OH and this is Cl first suppose. Okay. So now here this is optically inactive isomer. It's not an optical isomer because this one has no chiral carbon. Okay. So meso isomer must have the chiral carbon, but it is optically inactive. This is optically inactive but has no chiral carbon. It's not an optical isomer at all. But meso compound is optically inactive. That is optical isomer. Okay, that is optical isomer. That rotates the plane polarized light. Meso compound rotates the plane polarized light. But due to internal compensation, its optical activity is zero. Okay. Now here in this case, this molecule cannot rotate the plane polarized light, but meso compound can rotate the plane polarized light. But due to internal compensation, meso compounds are optically inactive. Okay, yeah. And next here, see this one. If N is odd, first suppose CH3C, your OH, your hydrogen, your CH, your OH, CH, OH, and CH3. Now here 1, 2, 3. Here n equals to 3 actually. Here n equals to 3. So here in this case here, n equals to 3 means here odd number. So here number of stereoisomers, number of stereoisomers equals to 2 power of 3 minus 1. That equals to 4. So here in this one, active isomers equals to 2 power of 3 minus 1 minus 2 power of 3 minus 1 by 2. That equals to So actually here 4 minus 2, that equals to 2. Okay, 2 active isomers. Total isomers 4, active isomers 2. That means here inactive isomers are meso isomers equals to 4 minus 2, that equals to 2 only. Okay, but here in this case here, you may get one doubt. Here this carbon is not a chiral carbon. Okay, this carbon is not a chiral carbon. Okay. So here in this case actually here I have taken this one as a chiral carbon. Okay, this chiral carbon is nothing but pseudo chiral carbon. This is pseudo chiral carbon. Okay, how it is a pseudo chiral carbon? What is the meaning of the pseudo chiral carbon? You can see here in this case, you see CH3, this one CH3, your OH, this one is a OH, this one is a OH, hydrogen, this is a hydrogen, this is a hydrogen. So here in this case here, there is a plane of symmetry. The molecule can be cut into two equal halves along this direction. So it is a meso compound. Now here in this case, CH3, OH hydrogen, this is a OH hydrogen, HOH, this one also meso compound that can be cut into equal halves. These two equal halves are the mirror images. Okay, but these two are not identical. Generally we are saying that meso compounds are identical. Here these two meso compounds are different spatial element. Okay, here all OH groups on the same side, here all OH groups are not on the same side. But it is inactive isomer, it is inactive isomer, it is a meso, it is a meso. These two meso compounds are not same. Okay, these are the two different isomers. Now here in this case here, what is the relation between these two meso isomers? That may be diastereomers. Of course, yeah, these two are the diastereomers because not mirror images. Okay, these two are not in mirror images. Now here in this case, you can see here what is the meaning of pseudo chiral carbon. Here CHOH CH3, CHOH CH3. These are structurally same. But if the configurationally those two are different, then this chiral carbon is a pseudo chiral carbon. You see this one. This is the first priority, this is the second priority, this is the third priority. Okay? So here clockwise direction, but hydrogen, least priority group on the horizontal line, so we have to take the reverse way, yes, configuration. Now here first priority, this is the second priority, this is the third priority. Okay? You know that CAP rules, Kane, Ingold, Prelog rules, I discussed at the geometrical isomerism. Okay? So here 1, 2, 3, anti-clockwise, yes, configuration, but least priority group on the horizontal line. So here in this case, you can take the reverse R configuration. That means here, these two groups are structurally same, but configurationally different. So in this case, this carbon is a pseudo chiral carbon. Pseudo chiral carbon. Now here, if it is a chiral carbon, that must have the one configuration like either R configuration or S configuration. So how to give the configuration to that sudo chiral compound. Okay, sudo chiral compound. Now you can see here. Here OH first priority. Now here these two are the structurally same. How to decide the priority? Now in this case here, the group which has the R configuration getting a more priority over the group which has a F configuration. Okay, so your first priority, this is second priority, this third priority. So your cross priority, but take the reverse way. Yes, sir. So here this pseudo chiral carbon is denoted by this small S. Okay, that's it. Now here in this case here, this is the configuration S, this is the configuration R. So here pseudo chiral carbon configuration is R. Okay, because your OH on the right side, your OH on the left side, so its configuration small r is the pseudo chiral carbon. Now here, what is the enantiomeric phase? That means here, what are the two active isomers in this case? CH3, this one CH3. Your OH, your hydrogen, this is a OH hydrogen. This is OH hydrogen. Now here, its mirror image CH3, this one CH3. So OH hydrogen. This is OH hydrogen. Sorry. This is a hydrogen, this is a OH. Hydrogen, this is a OH. This is a dextroisomer, then it is a levo isomer. Okay? These two are the mirror images. Okay? Then, that's why here I have taken this one as a chiral carbon. But actually it is a pseudo chiral carbon. Okay? Actually that is a pseudo chiral carbon. Okay? That's it. Yeah. Now let us continue our discussion. That means here just applying for some more molecules. Okay, so here see this one. Now it is a symmetric molecule. So here this is a Cl above the plane. Here sorry, Cl 1,2 dichloro cyclohexane. Here in this case how many stereoisomers actually? So here actually two chiral carbons. So n equals to 2 only. So in this case total stereoisomers are the 3. Okay. So here above the plane chlorine, now next below the plane chlorine, above the plane chlorine, its mirror image, okay, its mirror image. Okay, now here this optically inactive molecule, okay, it is a meso compound, there is a plane of symmetry, meso compound, now here no plane of symmetry, these are the optically active. So here in this case here, dextro trans isomer and levo trans isomer, okay, dextro trans isomer. Levo trans isomers. For this one here, three isomers are possible totally. Okay? Now. Yeah. So next here, this is the chlorine, this is the chlorine. For this one also, three isomers are possible. Above the plane chlorine, above the plane chlorine, there is a plane of symmetry, so it is a meso compound. Now here, so above the plane chlorine, below the plane chlorine, now its mirror image, below the plane chlorine, and here above the plane chlorine. Okay, this is an enantiomeric pair. Okay, that's it. Now here, let's say, let us discuss that. Yeah, one example, CH3CH, double bond CH. A CH, this is a OH. CH, double bond CH. CH, what is the N value actually? It is a symmetric molecule. Here, N value is 3. Okay, N value is 3. How... I have taken n value 3 here. Actually, these two are the structurally same. Then this carbon is not a chiral carbon. But this carbon is a pseudo chiral carbon. How it is a pseudo chiral carbon? Here in this case, these two are the structurally same. But whenever this is cis configuration, this is a trans configuration, then configuration is different. So then I can take this one as a chiral carbon. When it is a cis configuration, this double bond configuration is cis, then this carbon is not a chiral carbon. Okay? So here n equals to 3. So number of, yeah. So here in this case, so number of stereoisomers 2 power 3 minus 1 equals to 4 actually. So here in this case here, I should not consider this one as a chiral carbon. Because these two groups are structurally same. But here I have taken it, this one has a chiral carbon. Because whenever its configuration is cis, its configuration is trans, then it become a chiral carbon, nothing but pseudo chiral carbon. Okay, so about the pseudo chiral carbon, I recorded already, there is a one video, so we can see in a description. Okay, I have given a link. So in this case here, cis isomer is cis isomer, optically inactive. Trans isomer, trans isomer, that means their configuration about this double bond trans, here trans, so optically inactive. okay, it's not a chiral carbon. It is a cis, it is a trans, then it becomes a chiral carbon. So for chiral carbon configuration may be R or S. So these two are the mirror images, one enantiomeric pair, okay, that's it. So here in this case there are no meso compounds or phosphates. Okay, next here another example, here N equals to 3 actually. So but total three isomers are not 4. These two examples are somewhat similar examples. But here for this compound here the formula is not applicable. Okay, formula is not applicable. You can see in this case here R configuration, about this one cis configuration, here R configuration. Okay, so now it's mirror image, S configuration, cis S configuration. R configuration, trans R configuration, it's mirror image, S trans and S configuration. Okay, that's it. Now, and next, yeah, R configuration, cis S configuration. Now it's mirror image, you can see S configuration, cis R configuration. Now R configuration, trans S configuration. Mirror image for R, S, for trans, trans, for S, R. Now here, this is the active isomer, this is the active isomer. This is the active isomer, this is the active isomer. Now here, these are the inactive isomers. Okay? Now here, these two are the meso compounds. These two are the meso compounds, nothing but identical. Those two are the identical. Okay, now here, these two are the meso compounds, nothing but identical. Okay, of course, these are not the identical because even R configuration, S configuration same, but about the double bond configuration is different. This isomer, trans isomer. Now here, how simply I could say this is a meso isomer. Now here, see this one. You know the tartaric acid, OH, here hydrogen. Here OH, hydrogen. This is COOH. Here first priority and this is the second priority, this is the third priority. 1, 2, 3, clockwise R configuration, but a hydrogen on the horizontal line. So, reverse. So, for this one, first priority, second priority, this one, third priority. 1, 2, 3, S configuration, but take the reverse, R configuration. So, actually it is a meso tartaric acid. You know that simply, it is a meso tartaric acid. So here, from this one we can understand, for a meso compound, configuration of the chiral carbon is exactly opposite. Okay, here R configuration, S configuration. Now here, if you take active isomer, configuration of those two chiral carbons is same. Here hydrogen, this is the OH hydrogen. So OH on the right side, its configuration R, its configuration also R. Here OH on the right side, S configuration, OH on the left side, R configuration. So configuration must be same. So for meso compound configuration is different. So in this case here configuration different, symmetric molecule, optical inactive, that is a meso. Okay, here R configuration, S configuration, opposite configuration, symmetric molecule, optically inactive compound. This is a previous IITJ advanced question. Okay, now here in this case, for cis isomer, C double bond C, this is the one group, this is the one group. Here hydrogen, this is a hydrogen. This one actually has a plane of symmetry. Now here, for R isomer, here hydrogen, this is a hydrogen, this is a chiral carbon group, this is a chiral carbon group. Okay, that means here CHOH CH3, it has a center of symmetry. Okay, center of symmetry, it is a sigma. It is optically inactive due to plane of symmetry, it is optically inactive due to center of symmetry. Okay, that's it. Now, one more example. Let us discuss here. You see this one. All six carbons are attached to the OH group or Cl group. For this one here actually inositol. This is called as inositol. For this one, seven geometers. Sorry, total isomers are 9. Total stereoisomers are 9. Okay. This is one exceptional compound. Okay, you can see the difference to isomers in Google by typing inositol isomers. Okay, so total stereoisomers are 9. Here in this case, total stereoisomers 9, 7 are inactive. 7 are inactive. Here 2 are active isomers. Optically active 2 isomers and 7 are optically inactive isomers. Okay, So for this one, product isomers are 9. Okay, for this molecule, only geometrical isomers are 8. Okay, only geometrical isomers are 8. Only geometrical isomers are 8. Among the 8 geometrical isomers, one isomer is optically active, exists in a dextro and levo. Okay, that's why total isomers 9 actually. Okay, 7 are inactive, 1 is active, means dextro and levo. So 7 plus 2, so that equals to 9 total isomers. Okay, yeah, that's it. So that is our calculation of the stereoisomers. So thank you for watching.